chapter number 19. Luke chapter number 19. We are in the season of Lent. This coming week is what we call Holy Week. And this coming Friday, which is Good Friday, I would like for you to join me in prayer this Friday. I'm going to open the altar up for the 12 hours, amen, of the day. I want to open it up all day. I want you to come in and spend an hour of prayer. You can spend two, you can spend three. We must commemorate what Jesus did for us in a very real and tangible way. If we were to have been at the Salvation Army this coming Friday for our services, however, they have postponed those services, so we will not be having that Good Friday service, but we will be here for prayer.
Amen.
We must come and celebrate the suffering of the Lord Jesus. So you will hear it again on this coming Tuesday Bible study. We will be here this Friday all day for prayer. Amen. Somebody need to help me say amen.
Amen.
Praise God. They hung him high and they stretched him wide.
Yes. Yes.
Just for me. And just for you. And so that's the least we can do on Saturday, on Friday, is to be here in prayer. Amen. And we will be here from 9 to 9. From 9 a.m. in the morning until 9 p.m. in the evening. I ask you to come and spend a couple hours on the altar. Because not only is he dying, there's some stuff in us need to die.
Yes. Amen.
There's some stuff in us need to die. And we don't need to see resurrection with that same stuff in us.
Amen.
I'm going to serve communion all day on Friday. For those of you that want to go to the Lord's table, I'm going to serve communion all day on Friday. And we're going to die, do some dying up in here.
Amen.
If fasting is in your view, go ahead and do it. Turn your plate over. You can do it for 12 hours. Man, I wish I had some.
Amen.
I thought we said we was here for him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. So this coming Friday, from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., 12 hours of languishing before the Lord, we will be here in prayer. We're going to languish. Because of what he did for me, is the least that I can do.
Lord, hallelujah.
Praise God. I need a church.
Amen.
That will say amen.
Amen.
Praise God, I need you to be able to be present. Most of you have some time off from work. They do honor that as a Christian holiday. One of the very few holidays that they will give you some time off is Good Friday.
Yes. Yes.
So take your 3 hours and come and lay on this altar. And get on these palms and lay on these palms. And die. Let some stuff in you die. Amen. Let some stuff around
Amen.
You now. Praise God. I want to thank God for the prophetic word of God, the prophets of God needed. Amen.
Amen.
He's not here this morning. He's working this morning. But I want to thank God for Prophet Cedric Blank.
Yeah.
A word spoken sometimes, if you have a prophetic mouth, is not to be taken lightly, but I just thank God for him on yesterday, just a spoken word, not even to me. But when the prophet is in the place, sometimes you don't think the prophet is prophesying to you, but you have to be discerning. Amen. You have to be discerning to pick up when God is talking to you. Amen. So this Friday, we're going to do some dying, killing some things in us and killing some things around us. Because in this hour, listen, the enemy is accurate as ever. The enemy is as accurate as ever. He's never been more accurate. The devil has never been more accurate. His accuracy is at 1,000%. He knows exactly what to bring you that will abort your next move. He knows what it is. He knows what it is. And his accuracy is at 100% in this hour.
Yeah.
You gotta kill him.
Amen.
You just gotta kill him. Ain't nothing you can do about it. You gotta kill it. It'll Amen. Pop up again, but you gotta kill it every time you can hear it.
Yeah. Amen.
So this coming Friday is Good Friday. It's a good day for us to die.
Amen.
Those of you that's not working, spend the whole 12 hours. Those of you that's working, come after work. Those of you that get that 12 to 3 hour is, come and lay on the altar. Amen. He died just for me. He died just for you.
Amen.
And that's the least we can do is die for him.
Amen.
Amen, somebody.
Amen.
I mean, righteousness is still right.
Yeah.
Or holiness is still holy.
Yeah. Amen.
Yeah. Amen.
Amen.
Go with me to Luke chapter number 19. I'm going to read two verses and I'm going to be out of your way. We've been talking about the things that we need to let go of in Lent. First thing we talked about was poverty. We have to let go of that. That's a mindset that we must eliminate in our life. And then we talked about quitting. We said we have to let go of this mindset that anytime I get angry or anytime I get frustrated, that I have the right to quit. So those are the two things. We're going to keep this series going even after the resurrection for a little bit, because I want you to hear some of the things that I believe need to die in the mindset of God's people. Amen.
Amen.
Luke chapter number 19, if you're there, say I'm there.
I'm there.
Amen. And the pericope is really from verses 28 to verse 40. The actual text that you would read for this is in your bulletin. And we have an insert of all the scriptures for this week. Please take them home and meditate on them. But I want us to look at verse 39, and I'll start at verse 38. Blessed is the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Peace in heaven and glory in the highest. Verse 39, and some of the Pharisees called to him from the crowd, Teacher, rebuke your disciples. And verse 40, but he answered and said to them, I tell you, that if these should keep silent, the very stones would immediately cry out. You may be seated in the presence of the Lord. Amen. For just a few moments. Thank you for the greatest worship team in the world.
Amen.
Thank you. Let me do honor. Pastor Billy Hall is with us this morning. All the precious saints that have come to her. Today is Friend and Family Day, and I know that with all of the emphasis on the anniversary, it might have been skipped. So I do apologize for that. Amen. So try it again next week.
Amen.
Amen. Let's not wait for next year. Let's go ahead, amen, and try it again next year. Three things. One thing that we must let go of in this season is poverty. Amen. Pull out your notes for that. Poverty is really an insult to God. And by poverty, I don't just mean the lack of resources or money, but it's a mindset. We discussed a few weeks back that God has given us the power to get wealth. And the power to get wealth is our pain and suffering. The power to get wealth is our pain and our suffering. So when we go through those types of incidents in our life, God is creating within us the components that we will need to overcome our poverty. Lack of wealth, lack of resources. The Church of Jesus Christ must become untangled financially. We must become untangled. I was just having a conversation with Sister Cheryl earlier. We think about what God is asking of us in this season, and you divide it by 30, you would see basically how little it really is that God is asking you to give. I'm going to say it again. The assessments for this season and the anniversary, when you divide it by 30, divided by 30. Just think about it. But what happens is we are so entangled. We're so entangled that we don't realize that the spirit of poverty is on us, even though we have liquidity, even though we have money, even though we work jobs, a spirit of poverty is on us. And we have to break that spirit of poverty. Think about $1,100 divided by 30, it's going to come out to about 30 cents or so. And divide this thing about what that is, and think about when you work for that for 30 years. Many of you, if you were not getting your weekly or monthly compensation, you would quit your job. Testing one, two.
Amen.
Am I talking to the right
people?
Yeah. Amen. You would not be in any place where you were not compensated fairly. Is that right?
Right.
Yes.
But a spirit of poverty is always around, particularly when we have to give back. We don't have a problem with receiving, it's giving back. And that is, again, a spirit of poverty. So during this season of Lent, we want to look at during this whole year, the year of preparation, because you're going to have to invest in your future. And whatever it costs you, you're going to have to pay that to go where you're trying to go.
Yeah.
Amen. Got quiet right
there. Amen.
I'm just walking it down slow. Praise God. Because the spirit of poverty has attached itself to the working saints. Now, I'm not talking to people who are in a wilderness or in a struggle. I'm talking about working folk who are struggling still financially because a spirit of poverty. A spirit of poverty has caused you, without you knowing, very suddenly, to get into a cycle that is not kingdom life. Kingdom life is always having more than enough. That's kingdom life. Paul said that I would that his grace would be upon you in such a way that at every opportunity, you would have more than enough to give, to share. Amen, somebody. How many of you want to live in that dimension where you always have more than enough? That whatever is asked, whether it's in your natural life, whether it's in your church life, that you never have to count your money no more. Am I talking to the right church? Praise God. Amen. So it's not so much just the budget. It's not so much income or revenue. It's not just so much what goes out. It's the spirit. It's the spirit of poverty. And when we go through things, God gives us the power to get wealth through our pain and our suffering and learning how to monetize that to create sustainability, to create multiple streams of income. So that you now, if one stream is weak, you have seven more that are strong.
Amen.
I must be talking to the wrong church.
Yes.
Am I talking to the right church?
Yes.
I don't want to wave your hand at me. Is that my nephew? Is that Arvin? Oh, that's Uncle William. Oh my God. He scared me. I thought it was Daddy at first. could you praise God for my brother? Amen. Amen. Us to come into a place, Church of Jesus Christ, where you can fund the church.
Amen.
Where you can fund the programs of the community, where the church can take an offering.
Amen.
And the need of a community can be met.
Amen.
Am I talking to you? Is the kingdom. This is kingdom life, kingdom living. Then the second thing that we said was that we have to get over this spirit of quitting. That dreams don't die, but dreamers quit. That you have to avoid getting so angry and so frustrated during your process that you do not quit. That quitting is never an option for God's people. through is tough. The process for kingdom living is tough.
Yes. Yeah, yeah. Amen.
But you cannot get so angry and so frustrated during your process that you quit. Because dreams never die, but dreamers quit. Who I'm teaching good on is still good in the atmosphere. Amen. Go back and think about all the things, amen, that's in your heart to do. But the process, I heard somebody say the laborious process. The process, the pain of the process calls you to get angry or frustrated and you move into quitting. So sometimes you have several places in your life where different parts of your dream, they're still there discombobulated because you gave up. The dream did die. But you quit. This is the area where a lot of believers really need mastery over their emotions.
Yeah.
I'm teaching so good. Yeah. I'm not going to say nothing else about 5 seconds. Because that's too good. I can't just bombard you with that. I need you to see that. The saints need mastery over their emotions.
Yeah.
Say it over here on this side, because this side went down. The mastery of the saints in this hour will be that you have over your emotions.
Yeah.
Ooh-wee.
Oh, yes.
Because the dream will never die. It is your emotions. It's your lenses, how you perceive things. How you see things, how you perceive people see you, that cause you to quit. And the enemy is 100% accurate in this hour to make you think that everybody is against you. Ooh, somebody ought to hear me. Why? So you can quit your dream and die in poverty. So you can quit your dream, so you can give up on your dream and die in lack. Let me decree something. I don't want to bury another saint because you did not have no money. Hello, somebody.
Yeah.
I just said something so good.
Yeah.
This has got to be the hour now when you are preparing for your purpose, for your destiny. Jesus Christ did not just come through what he came through for you to die and go to heaven. He said, occupy until I come. Oh, God, that was good. He said, take territory until I return. He said, dominate, subdue, and replenish until I return. Ooh, glory to God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Ooh, hallelujah.